Hi friends, have all a nice Sunday. Today I'm picking for you this old, pretty nice German lever padlock. It's a two-lever lock. Sadly, I don't have a key for it, but I will use this video to make a little tutorial for you, which might get you started picking your first lever locks, or might give you at least a couple tips. So let's start with the picks. Here I have some made from 1 millimeter thick meat skewers, pretty robust material and stainless steel. I will show you in a second a cheat sheet with dimensions roughly. I have flattened the sides which rests on the bolt or on the levers, which just helps to keep them on and not slipping. And then I have also a little, some little bigger picks made from 1.5 millimeter steel welding wire. This one is here copper plated, also relatively robust. Obviously a little bit bigger for bigger locks or locks with longer keys. And I often combine them, so I use maybe the smaller tensioner with a bigger lever pick or vice versa. It depends really on the lock. And just to get you a starting point, I've painted down some measurements. I hope you can read them. Here the small meat skewer picks and here the bigger welding wire picks. It's really only a starting point, especially the length here on the handle. This is made for picking it in the vise. It's not good for picking it in the hand when they are way too long, here the handles. But you might get a rough idea. And here, once again, I show you where I tension the lock. Here is the tensioner, rotating it clockwise. Here you are on the bolt, which is going back and forth. You want it to go, of course, most of the time to the right to open the lock and give a shackle fee. And then you have here the levers, which have a little cut out, where a little notch or a bolt from the bolt is going to. Some locks don't have this cut out on the bottom, some have false gates, some don't have these cutouts on the end. But you have a little rod and you want to lift the levers to a place where this bolt can slide through the middle here. And if you don't have this cutout on the bottom, you can simply overlift the levers, so pushing them all the way up, and then they go straight to. But it's not on every lock. This one I will pick for you does have also cutouts on top and bottom. And I will use the thicker picks for this, because they are simply longer. Good way to determine the length is the height of the keyway here. You can see this is a little bit long here. You can measure from the middle to the end of the keyway. But it gives you a starting point. Also the tensioner here, roughly about the height from the middle of this pole to the end. It's actually not that simple on every lock. You have to really experiment. And I like to go in sideways, all the way to the back, rotate it to the bottom. Hope you can see it. And then I pull it to the front and feel for a little bit resistance. Then turn it back and try to get the bolt. And I think it is somewhere here around. Can see the shackle move a little bit if you look closely. I think I might be on the bolt. I know on this lock there's a little metal piece protecting the bolt from the backside. So sometimes I'm on this. Okay, when you insert the lever pick, you see it is longer, so that you are not in the way. Probably way too long for me here, but it actually works. Here's one lever in the front. You can see it is nice and springy. Then there's a little gap between the levers. And then here is the second lever around here, I think. I have actually not. Okay. Okay, and here we are. So you heard very nice and fat clicks from this one. Sometimes I get only a tiny little click from the first lever, which actually you count from the back. So here's the first, here's the second. Get a tiny click from the second lever, which is from the first lever, which is binding first. And then I get a click from the front lever, and then it gets open. And one thing I like to do, and first I try to show you the inside a bit, if my light will work. I'm not sure if you can see it, but here you can see the two levers, one in the front when there's a gap, and the second lever, and next to the second lever is the bolt, and then there's this guard plate, I would say. Pretty interesting, actually. One thing I do like to do is to pick it also closed. For this, I can remember you on the picture. You have to go on this side, which is actually now shifted a bit. So you try to get your attention on this angle of the bolt and rotate it counterclockwise. And we do the same all the way to the back. Rotate it and feel for resistance. Sometimes it's actually not that easy, but you can see the shackle moving again, which is a pretty good indication that you are on the bolt. I'll try to hold it here with my thumb, and it's actually not that hard on this lock to get it closed. I have to only push the second lever up a little bit, and here it is fully closed again. And you can check this even by just going back on the bolt, and you see it is not opening, so it is really closed. I hope it helped you a little bit. I hope you had fun picking together with me this nice little lever padlock. You will see a couple more. I have two more nice ones, which I got this week. Have all a great Sunday, and see you in the next picking video. Bye.